Hey guys, in this video we're going to set up a Ruby on Rails shopping cart, and we're going to be using the Spree Commerce gem, which is a really powerful gem that gives us a full-featured shopping cart in just a few commands, really. So we'll set that up. We're going to be using Postgres for our database, so that's the first thing we're going to do. And I'm using Ubuntu 14.04. We're using Ruby on Rails version 4. And I already have it installed. I used RVM to install it. And if you don't have it installed and you don't know how, then watch my Ruby on Rails RVM installation video. All right, so I'm going to open up a terminal, and the way that I'm going to install PostgreSQL, I'm going to add a list, a repository. All right, so I'm going to paste this in. Okay, you want to copy it and then just run it. Okay, so that adds that list, and I have one more I'm just going to grab real quick so I don't have to type it out. Okay, so you want to run this wget. Alright, now that that's added, we can do an update. Okay, and now we can do an install. And we want to install PostgreSQL-common. Yes. All right, and we want to run install PostgreSQL dash 9.3 libpq dash dev. Okay, so what we want to do now is create a user, a Postgres user. Alright, create user, and I'm gonna make the user the same name as my application that we're gonna create, which is gonna be my store. And then just add that S flag. Okay, so we want to assign a password. So Postgres PSQL, and then we just want to do password and the name, which is my store, and then enter the password, which will just do my store. All right, and then we can exit that, Control D. Now we want to generate our Rails application. Okay, so I'm in my home directory, and I'm just going to say Rails new my store, and I'm going to specify that we want PostgreSQL. All right, and what that'll do is it'll add the PG gem for us and set it as our default database type. All right. So now we want to, I'm going to be using Sublime Text for my editor. Feel free to use whatever you would like. And I'm just going to add the project folder. Okay, and if we look at our gem file, you should have the PG gem instead of the SQLite 3 gem. If you don't, just comment the SQLite 3 out and add that. All right, so next thing to do is our database configuration file, which is right here. And we just want to add some stuff here. So we want to add the host. This is for the development environment. We want our username. Okay, now we don't have to create these databases manually. We can just run a rake command and it'll create them. So we'll do that in a minute. And the username, my store, password, my store, and then we want to do the same for the test database. Okay, so we'll save that, and then we want to run rake. Actually, we want to go into the directory, so my store, and then say rake db create. Okay, so we're getting a JavaScript runtime error, so you just need to install, I'm going to install node, so sudo apt get install Node.js, and that'll give us a JavaScript runtime. You can also use the Ruby Racer, but Node should take care of it. So let's try the rake again. All right, so the database should be created now. So let's go ahead and run our server with Rails S. Okay, and we'll open up Chrome. Go to localhost 3000, and here is our application homepage. So if we click on the environment link, you should scroll down, and for database adapter, you should have PostgreSQL. All right, so that's all set. Now we want to install Spree, so I'm gonna shut down the server. And in order to run Spree, you need to have ImageMagick installed. So let's do that first. So sudo apt-get install ImageMagick, and it should end with a CK. Yes. And this is what will take care of product image generation, thumbnail generation, things like that, processing. All right, so now we want to actually install Spree. The Spree gem, and this could take a few minutes. I'm actually going to pause it and come back when it's finished. Alright, so we have the gem installed. Now we want to just run bundle install, and then we just want to say Spree install. Okay, it's going to ask us some questions. The default, do you want the default gateways? Just click enter for yes. Authentication, yes. Migration, yes. Seed data and sample data, yes. Okay, so it's giving us this message here because it's looking to use Git, and we don't have that installed. So let's just install it real quick. So sudo apt-get install Git core. And we just want to run that again, Spree install. Okay, so it's going to give us a default user of Spree at example.com. I'm just going to click enter for that, and password Spree123. Click enter, and then we can add another user once we have this set up. All right, so it says that Spree has been installed successfully. So let's go ahead and run our server. Say Rails S. And go ahead and reload our local host page. And you can see that we now have a full online shopping cart with products. Okay, so it's a very powerful gem. Okay, this is the main page. We can also click on a product, and it'll take us to that product's page with a name, a description, a price, an add to cart button, a similar items list. We have thumbnails for the image. And then we have the properties down here. We can also narrow it down by category, and we can narrow it down by brand and price range. Okay, so pretty powerful stuff just for a few commands. It's been under 10 minutes. Alright, so let's see the back end. We'll go to slash admin and we'll log in with the default, which is spree at example.com and then spree 123. Alright, so this is the back end system. We have our orders. Okay, we have some sample orders here. It gives you the state of the order, if it's pending or paid. Customer email. We have this big filter area here where we can narrow it down and search for specific orders. Okay, products. Same thing, we can narrow it down and filter by product. And you can see we have all these demo products. If we click on one, it's going to take us to the edit page for that particular product. Okay, all types of fields here. Taxons, which is basically different categories. Okay, option types. Okay, and up here you can see there's a bunch of sub items as well for properties, taxonomies. Alright, reports. Okay, so we can generate reports based on sales. Configuration. This is where you can set like the name, the store name. Let's just say my store. And SEO title. My store and keywords. And then over here you have other options for tax, zones, locations, payment methods. Okay, so to update, we can just click update. And then promotions, you can create coupons and promotions for your customers. Users is where you can manage all your customers and users. All right, let's create a new one. Okay, so I'm just gonna add Brad. websolutions.com password. Oh, we want to choose a role, so I'm going to check admin. Okay, let's update that. Okay, so now we should be able to log out and log back in with that user. Alright, so now we're logged in as that user, and you should probably either delete or disable the default user. So let's just go ahead and delete him. Alright, so that's the back end and the front end. Now, one of the first things you want to do is replace this logo with your own. So let's go to the front end, and you can go to this back to store link. Okay, now what we need to do to replace this, I have a logo here, just something quick that I made, and I'm going to copy it and then go to my application directory. So I'm going to go to my store, and then I'm going to go to app, assets, images, and paste it there. Okay, now just doing that isn't going to replace it. We need to specify it inside of our config file. So we want to go to, I'm going to open up Sublime, and I'm going to go to config initializers spree.rb, and then in here we want to say config.logo. And we're going to set that to logo.png. Now, the reason I don't need to specify a path is where I am in the assets images directory is the default for this image. Okay, if I put it somewhere else, I would have to specify the path. So let's just save that and see if that works. Okay, so now you can see the logo's been replaced. Now you may want to replace the admin one as well. You can see that it did not replace that. So to do that, we want to go back into that images folder and create a new folder called admin. And I'm just going to copy the logo and paste it in here. Okay, that still isn't going to do it. We need to specify that as well. So to do that, we're going to say config.admin_interface_logo. And we're going to say logo.png. If we reload that, now we have a backend logo. Alright, so what if you want to change the CSS? Alright, let's say we want the border around these images to be blue. Okay, we want them to be blue, and then if we hover over them, they'll turn gray. So basically a reverse of what they are. And that's just something I just thought of to give you an example. Alright, now the actual files for this, alright, the view files, the assets, they're coming from the gem file, which if we go to the home directory and I select show hidden files, and then we go to the .rvm folder, and then gems, and then Ruby, gems again, and then down here we should see Spree. Where is it? Spree front end right here. Alright, so this is where the view files are coming from. Okay, you can see all these view files, the home page. Alright, to start the assets, style sheets, okay, in the front end folder. Now we don't want to edit any of these. That's bad, because if we do an update, our changes will get overwritten. Okay, you don't want to do that. So we need to do some overriding. Okay, so I'm going to go back to the application, which is my store, and I'm going to go to vendor, assets, style sheets, Spree, front end. All right, and we can create a new document here, and let's just call it custom.css. Okay, and we'll open that up. And let's take a look at the CSS for this image. Okay, it's product image, and you can see over here it's got a border of gray. Okay, so what I want to do is reverse the border. I'm going to make it the border this blue color. So let me just copy this selector and go in here, and we're just going to change border color which will be this color. Okay, so you can see that now the border has changed color. If we hover over it, it's the same. So I want to change that. Okay, so we're going to say hover. Now if I hover, it turns gray. Okay, so that's how you can override the CSS. Now as far as the view files, if you want to edit the content, you can do an override like we just did. And you would do it inside app, views, and then we want to create a new folder called Spree. Alright, and you could put them here, but there's a more elegant solution, and that's to use something called deface, which is a library that allows you to overwrite elements, any element you want on a page. Okay, so let's, I'm going to give you an example of that. Now those are going to be done inside app overrides. Okay, now I'm going to create a document and I'm going to call it update underscore footer dot rb. Alright, and then we're going to open that up. And let's see what I want to override. Okay, so we have the footer and we have this powered by Spree. Okay, I'm going to inspect that. Okay, and you can see that it's wrapped inside of a div called footer left. Okay, so I'm going to target this paragraph tag inside of footer left. Alright, so let's go over the syntax of this. We're going to say deface override.new, and we're going to set virtual path. That's going to be spree slash shared slash underscore footer. This is the original file. Okay, so we're specifying what we want to override. And we're going to specify name. This is basically a description of what we're going to do. We'll say change footer text. All right, and then we're going to specify replace. And then what do we want to replace? Okay, so we want to replace div. Is it a div? No, it's footer. Yeah, it's a div with the ID of footer left. Okay, so div ID of footer left. Whoops, we don't need these curly braces. All right, and then we want to define text, which is what we want to replace it with. Okay, so let's actually, this should be div footer left p, and then we're going to replace it and put the p's back, but we want to change the text. We'll say my store copyright 2014. Okay, so we'll replace it with that and we'll save this. Go back, reload, and now you can see that it's changed to my store copyright 2014. Okay, so you can do that with absolutely any element that you'd like. Alright, you don't have to just replace, you can also add. So let's go ahead and add a phone number to the header. Okay, so we'll go back. Now this particular file is for the footer, and I should probably show you where these files are coming from, for instance the footer. So we'll go back to the RVM gems Ruby gems, and then we want spree front end. Okay, and if we go to app views spree, and you can see that we pointed to this spree slash shared slash underscore footer. That is pertaining to this here, shared, and then we have underscore footer. And we can take a look at that. Whoops, I didn't want to open it with that. And this is what it looks, whoop. Let's close this up. Okay, so this is that footer file that we overwrote. Alright, you can see it has the link to Spree, it has the powered by text. Alright, so what I want to do now is add to the header, which is in this file, underscore header. Alright, and you'll notice that when we overwrote it, we have an update. We had update underscore footer. So now we need update underscore header. So I'm going to go back home and go to my store and then app overrides, and I'm going to create a new document called update header.rb. All right. And actually, I want to open it with Sublime. And I'm just going to copy what we have here in the footer. And do we want to change this? And then for the name, we'll say add phone to header. And let's see, we need to find an element in the header. Okay, so let's say the logo, which is a figure tag with the ID of logo. So I want to replace this target with figure ID of logo. I don't know why those curly braces just pop up. And instead of replace, we want to say insert after, because we don't want to replace the logo, we just want to put something in. Okay, and what we'll put in is a div with a class. We'll say header phone. Actually, this should be single quotes. Okay, so we'll save that. And there's the number. Actually, I'm going to add the text phone. All right, now we don't want it to just chill right there. We want to position this. So let's just go back to the CSS and we'll say dot header phone. Full position, absolute, and where do we want this? Let's put it up here above these links. So top, 0, and we'll say right, 0. And then let's make it a little bigger. Font weight, we'll say bold, and font size, say 17 pixels. Okay, so there's our phone. It's a little too big. So let's actually make this 14, and then we'll set padding bottom. Actually, yeah, the padding is not going to work. I just want to move it a little to the left. So from the right, let's go 5 pixels. Maybe a little more. Try 8. All right, so that's good. So that's how you can customize your store. Now, there's obviously a lot more you can do here. I think that's all. Oh, I wanted to show you how to add PayPal. Because right now, let's add something to the cart. Okay, and we'll go to checkout. Okay, and we want to put in our information here. Okay, I'm not going to save the address. And you can see that we have our shipping modules that the customer can pick from. Okay, now we're at payment, and we have the option for credit card and check. Okay, there's no PayPal option. So what we want to do here is, in the back end, go to configuration, and then payment methods. All right, and you'll see these are all the default payment methods. Let's go ahead and click on new payment method. And from the provider, actually, yeah, we have to, I want to use PayPal Express. and that's not here by default. So we need to get it. So Spree, PayPal Express, and this is what we want right here, the GitHub page, better Spree PayPal Express. Okay, and then down here it shows us how to install it. We just need to add this gem, except this says 2.2, we want 2.3, so we'll just make that change. So in the gem file, let's go down all the way to the bottom and paste that in and just change this to 2.3. Then save it and run bundle install. Let's shut down the server for a minute. All right, then we just gotta run, bundle exec rails g Spree PayPal underscore express install. Okay, you want to run the migrations? Yes. All right. So now we can go ahead and start our server. Okay, we'll go back and reload this page. And now we should see PayPal Express, which is right here. Okay, so now if we go to the front end and reload this payment page, we have a PayPal Express option. Okay, now if we try and pay, we're going to get an error. Okay, you do not have the permission to make this API call. That's because we didn't insert our API information here. We need the login, password, and signature. All right, by default, this is in test mode, so we want to use PayPal Sandbox just to test. Alright, so if you don't have a PayPal Sandbox account, I suggest making one. Basically, it's just a fake PayPal account. Alright, so you want to sign up, and it has nothing to do with your Rail Bank accounts or anything like that. I'm going to log into my account. I forget the password and username. One second, I'm going to pause this so I can get this information. Alright, so I'm going to paste in my Sandbox email and password and login. And even if you're not using Sandbox and you're setting up a standard payment, you still need this information. You still need to log into your regular account, PayPal account, and get this info. Okay, so what we're going to do is go to profile and then my selling tools. And then API access. You want to click this update link. Alright, so it'll give you these two options. We want to choose option 2 and view the API signature. Okay, now we need to copy these three things. Okay, we have the username. Whoops. Okay, we're going to go paste this into here, and then we need the password, not to be confused with your actual PayPal password, and then finally the signature. Okay, now let's go ahead and update. And then we'll go back to the payment page and now click PayPal Express and now it redirects us to PayPal to make our payment. All right, and then once the user pays, they'll go back to the site and the order will be fully processed. So that's it. We have a full functional e-commerce website in just over a half hour. So it's a really nice solution if you just need to get a store up and running. So thank you for watching, and please subscribe.